Hello everyone, and welcome back to Final Fantasy 13-2! Now in the last episode, we just left the Void Beyond, and we also opened this random locked location. So let's see what's here.
What the heck is this place?
Whoops, wrong turn.
So this looks like
some resolve the paradox, this place will stay
new
suspended
place?
In limbo.
Doesn't look like there are any other gates either.
Go back to the Historia Crux, Koopo.
Yeah, Monk is right. We should turn back.
Koopo.
So apparently it's a place still in limbo that we have to unlock somehow. Casino ticket. Oh, I guess this is a casino place. Oh, could we see inside? Not really. So let's head back. Doesn't look like we can do much here. Now this episode will have feature a lot of skipping here and there, because I do some side quests here and there. So, and like I said before, I don't really want to show all those stuff because they're not particularly plot interesting. I show some of the more plot interesting stuff here anyway, so hopefully you don't mind. So here we skip to the Brescia Ruins 300 AF. You remember the snowy area? So the main thing I wanted to show here was that I'm going to unlock another gate. So that's the main thing I wanted to show. Hey, this music is pretty decent actually. So anyway, we have a battle. Do we fight? I'd prefer not to. These guys are pretty tough, actually. So I'm gonna be taking the long route. Oh, luckily we managed to escape that. Chocobo. I don't like these guys. Be easier though if we didn't have to fight.
I think you guys took a wrong turn somewhere. The kiddie pool is that way.
Okay.
I think you guys.
Ooh, nothing interesting to say. So yeah, basically I'm here just to showcase me showing this area, I guess, again, and showing what you have. And the fights here are still pretty tough. I think at my level now I can take the guys on, but I prefer not to at this point in time. And I'm only showing this now just to show you me opening a time gate. So let's see how this goes. As you can see, there's the gate there on the left. But first things first, if you remember, there was a mission in the Brescia Ruins of 5 AF where someone asked us to find a flower. And oh, what's this? Some freaky looking silhouette. Monk is excited, so let's see what happens here. Hello.
Me and my buddy are out here doing research on monsters in the area, but I can't get a hold of him. Can you find him? He should have some sort of message for me.
So this is just another simple side quest. And I just have to go find someone. It's actually the guy that I talked to just now, I believe.
I'm counting on you two. Oh, by the way, he's a slightly odd fellow. A natural born jokester, if you will.
So yeah, but we're not doing that now.
Have you found him yet? He's very energetic. I'm a bit worried about my friend.
Nothing extra to say, okay. And if we see somewhere here, there's... Alright, here, yep. A silver petal. If you remember, someone in the other Brescia Ruins wanted this, so you find it here. So let's see, anyway, I think I'm... just checking if there's anything else here. Doesn't look like it. So let's try and open this time gate thing. Come on, Sarah. I do like, at least, even if it's the same area, you've got different weather systems going on, or even sometimes different layouts. Let's see how this goes. Yes. And we've opened the time gate. And we've opened another Yes Just Massive. Okay. And so I just wanted to show that. Me opening another time gate, and I'm heading back to the Brescia ruins here just to give back that silver petal.
You actually brought me a silver petal? But where on Pulse did you find it? Are you really giving this to me? Thank you. But I must confess, my niece is no longer around to admire it.
Oh well.
On the day that Cocoon fell, she died alongside so many others. It broke our hearts. She was just 5 years old. I'll never forget how much happiness she brought to our family.
Kind of a sad story.
Such a sweet girl, even if she was spoiled rotten. We were never able to find a place where she fell. I'll put the flower on the grave and say a prayer to her memory. Do you think our little princess will like the silver petal?
Maybe. A nice, touching, I guess, story about the events of Final Fantasy XIII.
Forgive me.
And Alyssa doesn't have much else to say, so let's head back to the Historia Crux and get on with this playthrough. Now, I'm heading to the Augusta Tower next. And this isn't actually a main part of the game. But it kind of makes more sense if you go to here anyway, so let's hear this first.
But now, centuries in the future, the system has suddenly begun to run amok. Somehow, the network system was attacked from somewhere in the future. When the Academy tried to respond and shut down the system, it was too late. The AI had already taken control of much of the Academy.
So, yep. This is like some building or tower that was built. I guess you'll learn more as the game progresses, so I won't spoil much. But basically, this is a side mission, I guess. But it kind of relates to one of the main missions, which is why I'm doing it, or at least why I'm showing it. Unlike all of the other side missions, which, well, they do have a bearing on the overall story of the game, but they're not really directly related to the main story of Lightning and
Two
Sarah and all.
From different times cannot coexist. If this were to occur, history would be infused with contradictions. This would lead to a distortion causing the entire world to collapse. The subjects require further analysis. Hypothesis: their existence has initiated a distortion in history, and the entities are a living paradox.
I'm not very good with all this fancy machinery. What's going on here exactly?
The system that controls this facility has been hacked by someone from the outside. Wherever they are, they're trying to use the network in an attempt to override the system somehow.
So basically, some bad guy snuck in and took over the tower? Well, there's an easy solution for that. We just need to find him and solve this whole problem. Case closed.
The security system's been hacked too, so the security bots are just pieces of metal. And I don't think the person behind this is actually physically here. It seems like the culprit isn't even in this time at all. They're accessing the system from somewhere in the future.
Lucky for us, we have the means to get there. Let's give them a piece of our minds. Come on.
Future Paradox has invested the Augusta Tower, turning its chambers and passages into a confusing maze. Restore the rooms to their correct positions to resolve.
We should flip the switch.
Well, I actually don't particularly like this area, honestly, because the backgrounds are too, I don't know, they may be funky or whatnot, but I just don't like it. And the puzzles are kind of,
yep, good.
Not really all that special, I guess. So yeah, there's some sort of maze here, and there are switches that rotate rooms, and when you connect the open doors and passages, you'll be able to move on. So let's see what we have here. So there are more switches, and there's nothing else. There's nothing this way, but well, I guess we have fights somewhere. Oh well. We have a treasure item, I could throw Mog. Go get him!
Come on, Mog.
And we get some money!
Awesome!
It was okay, I guess. But yeah, I don't particularly like this area. What can I say? Yeah, we are going to be spending a lot of time rotating these rooms. And yeah, there's all those numbers that's being spoken by some, I don't know, mechanical robot or something. I think you have to pay attention to it. But I can't remember if I really did pay attention. I think I paid some... a remote degree of attention to it, but somehow let's see if that affects anything. So I think we've had what, 1 and 2. Oh, and if you remember these guys, they were in the first game. They were annoying as hell to deal with.
It's hard to believe that all of this is happening because of one person hacking into the system.
I know, but it has to be. Maybe this is a paradox of some sort.
Can it go any further?
Yeah, so sometimes they don't even connect properly, so... As you can see, we need to do it one more time!
That's perfect!
And let's see if we can... Oh, yep, 3 now. Haha, a cutscene interrupted the fight. And there's some sort of elevator in the middle, for which we can head to the next area, I guess. So let's do this! I had no idea if there's going to be a boss battle here or something. Hopefully not. Okay, there's another elevator. I assume I have to use it to get to the next area or something. So I'm gonna have to find the correct path. Oh, Chocolina is here. Oh, let's fight him and see how it goes. Two enemies here, two new enemies. And yeah, you'll see me spamming third tier magics here and there a lot. Well, look at, and you can see that dude, the slime, is actually healing his companion. I think that's what he did in the first game as well. So we have to target him first in order to, because he doesn't heal himself, which is good. Taking forever to kill him though. Come on, kill him a bit more. Tiraga. So sometimes I like, you may have noticed that I've set my commands to highlight abilities straight away instead of auto attack. It's kind of, it helps in to a certain degree if you want to do stuff manually, because it makes things quicker and faster. It also helps if, you know, sometimes you just want to repeat a similar action, and you know, auto battle isn't exactly perfect, so which is why I use it that way. Hey, Chocolina.
Welcome, Master. I am here to serve your every need. Just kidding! Chocobocalina!
I don't think she has anything new or special. I'm still in the third chapter, so...
Everyone comes to me to stock up on...
Good for you, I guess. And more elevator pushing or rotating. Let me guess, I have to do it again, don't I? Oh, and there's a treasure item inside. Sweet, sweet.
Perfect.
Here, I'm just wanting to get that treasure chest item because I'm not sure if you can get to it some other way, so let's throw this mug. Just checking within yet if there's any other treasures or items, and we'll get this one too. I guess I do like how the camera is a bit different in this area, like it's a computer camera or something, a webcam I guess or something. But anyway, this is close to the end for this episode. I know we've been just...
Can it go any further?
Well, we did see a few things here and there. Opened a different time gate, although it didn't show me actually going to that Yasha's massif. Because that's basically a side quest. But we have a hidden item here, and we've come to this Augusta Towers, which is very different from any area we've been to before. So that's pretty cool and decent, even though I don't particularly like it. And we'll be exploring this further in the next episode. And we just have to rotate this one more time. And I'll leave you at this second elevator or lift. So thanks for watching, and I hope you enjoyed it. And well, see ya again next time. Thanks for watching.